My contribution to the debate is not a detailed description of migration processes, but rather it is an attempt to expose the fact that the contemporary post-optimistic society, dominated by postmodern culture, is marked by a destruction of social capital and certain degree of risk that gave rise to lifestyle diseases such as fundamentalism, dehumanization, disintegration of families, multiculturalism, and demographic that of the West. And to set the context of our presentation, I would like to use an excerpt of a homily Pope Francis's. In this world that you love more than we do, we have gone ahead at breakneck speed, feeling powerful and able to do anything. Greedy for profit, we let ourselves get caught up in things and lured away by haste. We did not stop, and your reproach to us, we were not shaken awake by wars or injustice across the world, nor did we listen to the cry of the poor or of our ailing planet. We carried on regardless, thinking we would stay healthy in a world that was sick. The current pandemic crisis makes it difficult to address the migration crisis in Europe. In the meantime, Europe has been riding the wave of multiculturalism and nationalism, and has stopped to build a culture of encounter and civilization of love and life. At the beginning, I want to point out main features of the condition of the current society. First, the second demographic transition. Very shortly, the processes of a second demographic transition, whose main feature is decline of fertility below replacement level, has its own autonomous ideological dimension, the postmodern culture of selfish individualism. It's a complex of changes in the behavior and value system of a population that overvalues individualism and personal freedom. Personal freedom, and at the same time, these changes weaken function of marriage and family and reduce natality to a level where it does not graduate self-reproduction of population. These changes are rather significant and can be defined as decline in birth, marriage, and abortion rates, and increases in divorce rate, contraceptive use, and number of children born out of marriages. Um, Features is postmodern destruction of social capital, postmodern culture, revolution of values, or the Christianization versus Islamization. We see the once clear distinction between good and evil fading against the ever more fragmented moral vision of human. Postmodernism transforms our immutable transcendence shaped objective into intersubjectivity. That is also why moral norms become not only the subject of social debate, but also its creation. Gradually, this leads to ethical relativism. This relativism, even ethical permissiveness, freed man from his traditional certainties and led to autonomy. All this gives impetus to very bold use, even exploitation of earthly reality and ultimately leads to the belief that it's possible to rule over it. Christianization versus Islamization. Religion in the context of the mentioned characteristics is understood as the only right and real institution, which is the guarantee and guarantor of truth, justice and order, integrity, in a society permeated by axiological chaos and injustice, unchecked consumption and egoism. Secularism as an ideology presents a worldview that rejects the existence of the sacrum, absolute truth and values. Belief in the world of global and imminent threat penetrating different areas of micro, meso and macro environment of human society, and by the paradox, this democratic and free society promotes a culture of discarding, a culture of insatiable greed, and apathy or indifference towards human suffering and poverty. Today our world has found itself in the abyss of international conflicts, religious terrorism and expanding Islamization, misusing the chapters of the Quran to distract and threaten human dignity, life, and the Western world. Very quickly about next features of postmodernism. Postmodernism is a stage in the development of civilization for which universal skeptical relativism impossibility of any definition and fragmentation of knowledge and the world, world as such are typical. Is also typical for ideologically understood pluralism, which means that knowledge, truth, justice, and human nature are just modalities of subjective experience of current reality. Relativism in terms of thoughts and values leads to repression. We are faced with aggressive secular politic vision and consumerist economic model that in reality results in a new form of atheism and totalitarianism that is as a matter of fact endorsed by the state. Next feature is globalization and religion. In the globalization process, first comes privatization of religion, and then its marginalization. A strong conviction that global religious system is simply not feasible as is being pushed forward. Religious life is being pushed to the private sphere and social sector. And theology within the framework of the humanities is to become the theology without God. Another feature of currently current society is the disintegration of humanistic universe. Modernism rejects the integral vision of a person. It refuses the fact that the person is anchored in the transcendence. It also negates the spiritualistic vision. It does not acknowledge the soul within the person, and accepts the model emphasizing the materialistic metrics of a person. As a result, the spiritualistic model that sees a human person as a being with a soul that was created by God is being pushed to the background. The materialistic metrics goes against the community because it promotes a lifestyle of selfish individualism and thus weakens and destroys interpersonal relationship. Degradation of family that came as a byproduct of the postmodern era, which saw the boom of alternative lifestyles, freely accessible and cheap contraception, trivialization of abortions, rising numbers of cohabitation unions, and endorsing the life motive of having fun for us for as long as possible with no consequences, resulted in the current state in which our society happened to find itself. In one of the studies, Dirk van der Ka describes socio-demographic characteristic of immigrants in Europe. It is typical for immigrants that the number of men usually exceeds the number of women. They have high birth rates and mortality rates, and by default they profess a religion other than the majority domestic society. From the above mentioned characteristic of immigrants, their high birth rate undoubtedly comes to the fore. Huntington picks up on this with the following comment. Migrants have high fertility rates and hence account for most future population growth in Western societies. As a result, Westerners increasingly fear that they are now being invaded not by armies and tanks, but by migrants who speak other languages, worship other gods, belong to other cultures, and they fear will take their jobs, occupy their land, live off the welfare system, and threaten their way of life. Huntington prophetically warns that the overall situation of social, cultural, and moral decay then leads to the stage of invasion when the civilization no longer able to defend itself because it is no longer willing to defend itself lies wide open the barbarian invaders who often come from another younger, more powerful civilization. We would like to focus on the Catholic Church's position of this issue and this reset proposal for resolving the migration crisis. A clear position on this matter is often presented by the Pope, which is why we find fewer divisions here than we see among secular experts. Pope Francis made it clear that all those who reject refugees and close the door to this to those who seek asylum should ask God for forgiveness. State officials and others who profess Christianity but reject refugees are hypocrites because Jesus would accept these people, as the Bible says, Christian should receive pilgrims. Rich Stearns concurs at and adds, instead of turning away from Syrian refugees in fear, we must see in them the wonderful opportunity to show the love of Jesus. He further expresses this conviction that Europe can find a middle ground between the responsibilities, protecting domestic rights and providing assistance and reception for migrants. Thank you very much.